Let's talk about the terror attack Tuesday, the explosion at a train station in Brussels. It is being treated formally as a terror attack. The suspect was wearing an explosive belt. He was shot by police officers. He had been shouting Allahu Akbar. Join me now, former CIA operative Mike Baker. It's almost a daily event in Europe, a terror attack of some sort, but not here. Why not here?
Yeah, no, it's a good question, but first of all, full marks to those who decided to treat it like a terror attack. Wearing an explosive belt, shouted Allahu Akbar, we're going to treat this as a terrorist attack. Yeah, that's probably the right move. It was a botched terrorist attack, meaning that the device didn't work as the terrorist had planned. But why not here on sort of the frequency, the level of violence that we're seeing? It may not be popular to say, but in part, perhaps it's because Europe is dealing with larger disaffected Muslim communities, and in part because of just the level of migration over the years. I'm not talking about the past year or two when it was headlines. I'm talking about since the 60s when it started really to build up. And they've had this policy for all this time, and we've talked about it before, the idea that you don't have to assimilate, in a sense. And it was never promoted, it was never pushed, it wasn't a key concept of the immigration policies for these countries. So they created these disaffected, disconnected communities, and it's coming home to roost now, I would argue. And we don't necessarily have that same problem here in the U.S.
I'm looking at some of the major cities in Europe, Brussels, for example. Don't they have a Muslim population that's approaching 15-16% of the Brussels population? And in Paris, if you look at greater Paris with the outskirts included, you're looking more like 17-18% is Muslim?
You are. You're climbing up. I mean, think about that, climbing up towards 20%. Paris is obviously the largest in terms of the communities there. Brussels, very significant, as you pointed out. London, obviously extremely significant. And that would be fine. Everything would be all well and good if you had communities who came in, and if they were coming to Germany, they were German first because this is their new adopted home, or they were British first. But that hasn't been the case. And again, that's a broad brush statement. Obviously, it is for a lot of them. For some, it hasn't been, and that's where the problem resides. They don't feel invested in the system. They don't see any hope, perhaps. But at the end of the day, people say, well, how do you stop this? How do you prevent an attack such as Brussels, an individual? Now, I guarantee you, I don't believe that individual prepared that explosive belt by himself. So there's contacts in there that they're currently, the Brussels authorities are looking at. But, you know, you can't stop those sort of attacks completely. So it's very frustrating.
At this moment, Europe, if I say Europe is terrorized, I'm probably going too far, but there's certainly a grave level of anxiety on people on the street. Right. But you don't get quite the same thing in America.
You don't get quite the same thing here, and I wouldn't use the word that the communities are terrorized. I wouldn't use that. Remember, there was a phrase in London saying, London is under siege. Yeah. No, they're not. London has seen worse, right? Yes. We all know that. And they'll be just fine. They're going to be very resilient. And they're working. The security services, the intel services are working. I keep looking for the bright side because my wife always says, every time you talk, people are depressed. And so I'm trying to find a bright side here, and that is that the security services over there in the EU, in the UK, here in the US, they know how to combat this. It has to be done on many levels. Community outreach, operational surveillance, monitoring, all of those things that have to work in concert with the laws. They know how to do it. But it's the almost impossible lift of stopping every one of these types of attacks. And people have to understand it. Doesn't mean we live with it. Doesn't mean we accept it.
It doesn't mean we get used to it.
But we have to be pragmatic and understand it.
Well said, Mike Baker. Thank